me Ishmael. Some years ago, never mind how long, having little money in my purse and nothing to interest me on shore, I put me down for a whaling voyage to sail about and see the watery part of the world. When on that winter's night the Pequod thrust her vindictive bows into the cold, malicious waves, a black, evil magic shivered in the air. A heathen crew that had small touch of human mothers in them. And housed in his cabin, there sat brooding a madman captain that no man aboard had ever seen. A madman with a stick of whalebone for a leg. For several days after leaving Nantucket, nothing above hatches was seen of Cap'n Ahab. It was a short, cold Christmas, and as the northern day merged into night, we found ourselves on a wintry sea whose freezing spray cased us in ice. When darkness came on, sky and sea split with thunder, blazed with the lightning. Then suddenly, I looked at the taffrail. There upon his quarterdeck stood Captain Ahab.
Mr. Starbuck, send everybody aft.
Captain Ahab, sir.
Send everybody aft.
Mastheads there! Come down!
Aye, sir!
But Captain Ahab, in a wind like this...
Muster all hands aft here.
Aye, sir.
All hands aft!
All hands aft!
Do you hear me there, men?
Aye, sir.
What do you do when you see a whale, men?
Sing out for him.
Sing out,
we sing out loud.
Sing out for him then, do you? And what do you do next, men?
Lower away and after him.
Aye.
That's right, Captain.
And what tune is it you pull to, men?
A dead whale or a stove boat.
Aye.
That's the tune, my boy. All ye mastheaders, have any of ye afore now heard me give orders concerning a white whale? Look, do you see this Spanish ounce of gold? A $16 gold piece, man, do you see it? Hand me yon top maul, Mr. Starbuck. I'll fix this gold piece to the mast. And whosoever of ye raises me a white headed whale with a wrinkled brow and a crooked jaw, whosoever of ye raises me that same white whale with three holes punctured in his starboard fluke, look ye, whosoever of ye raises me that same white whale, ye shall have this gold ounce, hey boys. It's a white whale, I say, a white whale. Skin your eyes for him, men. Look sharp for white water. If ye but see a bubble, sing out.
Captain Ahab, be that the whale some call Moby Dick?
Moby Dick. You know the white whale, then?
Does he fantail a little curious, sir, afore he goes down?
And a curious spout, too, Captain?
Have he one, two, three, good many iron in his hide, too, Captain?
Aye. The harpoons lie all twisted and wrenched in him. Aye, his spout's a big one, like a whole sock of wheat, and white as Nantucket wool. Aye, and he fantails like a split jib in a squall. Death and devils, men, it is Moby Dick. You've seen.
Captain Ahab.
Yes, Mr. Starbuck.
I too have heard of Moby Dick. But was it he took off thy leg?
Who told you that? Aye, Starbuck. Aye, me hat is all round. It was Moby Dick that dismasted me. Moby Dick that brought me to this dead stump I stand on now. Aye. It was that cursed white whale. Poor pagan lubber of me to the end of time. Aye, and I'll chase him round Good Hope, and round the Horn, and round the Norway Maelstrom, and round Perdition's Flames before I give him up. That's what ye've shipped for, men, to chase him on both sides of land and over all sides of earth, till he spouts black blood and rolls in out. What say ye, men? Will ye splice hands on it now? I think ye do look brave.
Aye. A sharp eye for a white whale. Sharp lance for Moby Dick.
Aye. We'll hunt him, Captain.
Aye. God bless ye, men. Steward, go draw the great measure of grog. Drink and pass, and rum for all. Rum, I say. Round with it, round. Long swallows, men. Long swallows. It's as hot as Satan's hook. It spiralizes in ye. Forks out of the serpent's snapping eye. Drink. Ye harpooners, drink and swear death for Moby Dick.
Aye.
Left harpoons, me cup bearers, drink me sweet cardinals. I commend the murderer's chalice to your lips. Drink and swear.
Aye.
God hunt us all if we hunt not Moby Dick. Ahoy, ahoy there aboard the Jeroboam! Have you seen the white whale?
Ahoy, the Reaper! What whale do you say?
The white whale! Sperm whale! Moby Dick, have you seen him?
No, sir. I've never heard of such a whale.
Curses throttle thee. Up helm, set all sail. Keep out of the wind.
Aye, sir.
Morning, Mr. Starbuck.
Good morning, sir.
Well then, Mr. Starbuck, what's the long face about?
No matter, sir.
Speak, man, would ye not chase the white whale? Are ye not game for Moby Dick?
I'm game for his crooked jaw. Game for the jaws of death, Cap'n Ahab, if all comes fairly. But I came here to hunt whales, not my commander's vengeance. How many barrels will your vengeance fetch in the Nantucket market, Cap'n Ahab?
Come closer, Starbuck. Money's not the measure of my lad. Let me tell ye, my vengeance will fetch a premium here in this hut.
Nay, sir. But vengeance on a dumb brute that spoke you from blindest instinct. It's blasphemous. Madness and blasphemy.
Back here, Mr. Starbuck. There's one God that's Lord over the earth and one captain that's Lord over the Pequod. Do you so much as dare think critically of me?
I spoke too rashly.
My conscience is in this ship's keel, Mr. Starbuck. And though my motive and my object may be mad, I'll hunt the white whale. I'm bound to hunt him, heart, soul, and body, lungs, and life. Do ye hear, though the wildest winds of heaven and earth conspire against me, I'll wreak my hate upon him.
Hunt him, then.
Wait, a dumb brute, say ye. Moby Dick is a murderous monster, strong and inscrutable, cunning, cruel, and remorseless, and sinewed with malice. Avast, man, have ye no bowels for a fight? Man up the crew, one and all, with Ahab. Would ye hang back when every foremost hand has clutched a western? Speak, man, speak.
God keep me, keep us all.
Can you say no more?
You're my commander. I must obey you. Ye need have no fear of me. But let Ahab beware of Ahab. Beware of yourself, old man.
Go below, Mr. Starbuck.
Aye, aye, sir.
Go below, down. Dog and kennel.
I'm not used to be spoke to that way, sir. I less than half like it.
Then be called 10 times a donkey, a mule, and an ass. And be gone or I'll clear the world of ye. Masthead there.
Aye, sir.
Look sharp, all of ye. There are whales hereabouts. If ye see a white one, split ye. Oh, the lightning flashes through my skull and mine eyeballs ache and ache. My whole beaten brain seems beheaded and rolling on some stunning ground. My heart is sick. I'll go below. It's like going down into a tomb for an old captain to descend this narrow scuttle down to his grave-dug bed. I seek my nightly grave to sleep between shrouds, and down I go, griping at the iron banister to help my crippled way. Hark to the crack and din of my bony step. My dreams will be of the crunching teeth of sharks. If I could sleep, old age is wakeful. The longer linked with life, the less man has to do with aught that looks like death. I leave a white and turbid wake. Pale waters, paler cheeks where'er I sail. The envious billows sidelong swell to whelm my track. Let 'em, let 'em. Yonder the diver sun, slow dive from noon, goes down. My soul mounts up. She wearies with her endless hill. Time was when as the sunrise spurred me, so the sunset soothed. No more, no more. This lovely light, it lights me not. All loveliness is anguish. Damned, subtly and malignantly, damned in the midst of paradise. Good night. Good night. And yet 'tis not too hard a task. I thought to find one stubborn at the least. What I've dared, I've willed, and what I've willed, I'll do. They think me mad, Starbuck does. But I am demoniac. I am madness maddened. That wild madness that's only calm to comprehend itself. The prophecy has been that I should be dismembered, and I lost this leg. But I do now prophesy that I'll dismember my dismemberer. Now be the prophet and fulfiller one. Ye great bully gods, I laugh and hoot at ye, ye deaf birds and blinded bendigos. You've knocked me down, but I'm up again. Ahab's compliments to ye. Come see if you can swerve me. Swerve me, swerve me. The path to my fixed purpose is laid with iron rails, whereon my soul is grooved to run. Or on sounded gorges, through the hearts of mountains, under torrents' beds, I'll rush. So will I fight ye, ye grim phantom futures. Stand by me, hold me, bind me, ye blessed demigods. Sinnoh! The white whale spouts!
Blood! I, Ishmael, was one of the crew aboard the Pequod. I, too, had sworn to murder Moby Dick, and as the days went by, the more did I hammer and clinch my oath because of the dread in my soul. A true whale hunter is as much a savage as any cannibal. But the harpooners aboard the Pequod were savages indeed. Tashtego, the blood-skinned Iroquois, Queequeg, a tattooed island aboriginal, and Great Dagoo, a giant coal-black African. The blacksmith's forge was on the deck, lashed fast by ringbolts to the foremast. And there the savages would crouch to worship fire. There, too, one day came Cap'n Ahab to watch the sparks fly and hear the hammer ring.